No matter the area or platform St. Louis Public Transit riders use, one problem is consistent. There's little security no matter if you board in St. Louis City or the county. That clear finding became even more evident when outside transit agencies came in town to pick apart Metro's issues in a $375,000 security study.
Everybody's getting involved, which we like, especially the community.
Charles Rapliga is a security consultant with WSP. He serves as one of the panelists to give a deeper look into the problems on the Metro.
I think before they were more of in a reactive mode. Everybody was just kind of reacting to what different things would go on the system. But I think now everybody's more in a proactive phase.
One crucial tip is addressing inappropriate behavior immediately and consistently. For example, if a conductor sees a rider smoking on the train, a new approach would be to alert that rider over the speaker system to extinguish the cigarette or face consequences at the next stop, essentially limiting altercations and improving relationships with riders. Right now, Metro has 44 officers from St. Louis County, 9 from St. Louis City, and 15 from St. Clair County. With that number of officers on the force, the consultants believe there should be a better coordination between the city and county, but that revelation came as a surprise to St. Louis County Police Chief John Bilmar.
I don't see that. You know, I think John Hayden and I work very well together. I think Sheriff Watson certainly works very well with the two of us. So I really don't see those kind of turf wars right now.
St. Louis City Police Chief John Hayden agrees and points to collaborations already underway to make riding Metro safer for everyone.
The takeaway, I think, is continue to work on your visibility plan. They talked about the surveillance that they have. We also have surveillance on the trains. And so it was encouraging to know that we have a lot of things in place that could mirror a lot of the things that they do in those cities.
Now with the issues laid out on the table, Friday's meeting serves as a starting point to push public transit forward in a positive way. In downtown St. Louis, Darion Henderson, News 11.